fence standards and number 8 wire in it, so. It's a New Zealand made piano. It's a Kiwi piano. It's stiff. They're actually just number 8 wire. It's stiff enough, and it's thicker than the usual pin that they use. Because these, I need thicker pins because of the balance of this, of the key. So yeah.
We've brought the thicknesses down those a few times, and I've used these.
It's the sound. The project's about the sound. Not about a record or anything like that. It's about the sound. The sound that I get from this big long bass string. That's what sort of got me started on the whole idea. It's very clear, it's very bassy. It's not like the usual grand piano that you come across. It's more unique. Sound. It's not completely different, and it's not, you know, completely out of place. It's just unique.
Well, before I started the piano, I tested it out. We whacked a waratah on the ground and strung up a 22-foot, 6-inch long string, and that was the A. And that was with a 13-gauge wire. And the sound from that is what is what inspired me, really. That was just one event that sort of got things rolling. And I asked my piano teacher how long a bass string would be without the copper wound round on it, and she said, oh, the string will go on forever. And that's, so I had to try it, I had to test it and see how long it was, because forever wasn't an answer for me. And this piano here is, haven't measured the long string, but it's not that long. It's only, the piano itself is 18 foot 9 inches.
I went up to a friend's house and I went up to visit them, and he said, oh, I might make a little piano up there. And then the tape measure came out and it was like, this is how long it's going to be. And I was like, oh, right, it's your dream piano, yay.
It's my perfect sound, really. As you say, like, a musician has their perfect sound, or a sound that they really try and get out of the piano. So I've put in this big string and I've produced this particular sound that I like. And because I like the sound, I want to make a piano to have it.
I started, the very first piece of this piano that I started was actually board that's underneath the veneer in there. So that's the first bit. And then I made this space underneath it, and I started the other side. And as soon as I got so far up the side over there, I started on the curve. And that I wasn't quite sure about that, so I laminated the strips up and down, which wasn't as strong as veneers going, being laminated along the curve. So that's why I've put that piece of steel on there. But it worked nice enough.
A very, very big piano. I'm pretty sure it's the world's biggest.
How big?
18 foot 9 inches. Oh, I started, the exact date was on the 24th of October 2005. That's the starting date. And so it's taken ever since then to get this far.
How old were you when you started?
Oh, 16, 17. Oh, they probably thought it was a bit crazy. not too many people knew, just sort of like locals and the neighbours, and it wasn't until it was in the paper that everyone sort of found out about it. And well, I'm cutting out the keys at the moment. That's what I'm doing, and making the bushings and all the really time-consuming work. So that's going to take quite a while, sort of working one key at a time and just getting through it.
another thing I find with the aluminium on the keys, they can actually bend them into place. If they were slightly out and you couldn't, and the pin was already in, they can actually bend them into place. You try not to do that so much. It works, so it's the one. As long as I don't bend back over time. The first problem I had with the keys was they would warp. So I got some cedar, I bought some cedar, and I thought, well, I'll put some aluminium on the top to help stop it from warping, and they haven't warped at all. Haven't moved at all, so that's been good. It's good when things go to plan. The keys. The keyboard's an 85er, so it's got 85 keys. It doesn't go right up to C, but I don't use those notes anyway. So I've spent all my time cutting these out, blowing them up. They've had epoxy resin in between the gaps, and cedar and aluminium. Oh, you have your ups and downs. The pen has had its moments, but yeah, you get through that. Once you've come so far, it's sort of, as long as things are working out, and keeps enthusiasm going. Like, there was a point where I was making keys and they didn't work, and then I tried another way of doing keys and they didn't work, and I was starting to get a bit frustrated until I come up with this idea of using cedar and aluminium. But yeah, it has its moments. I find a brake helps. I've had a few breaks from it, and that keeps me going.
Adrian, he does like a bit of time out from it every now and again, and we might be going away to simply mow the sheep somewhere or do some bits, and he'll come with us and help us do that just to get away from it for a bit.
I would like to get it finished by the end of the year. That's my date. But my date and the actual finish could be a long way off, but I'm hoping it'll be finished by the end of the year. I like, especially at the end of the day, where things sort of get hard, I just come here and pluck the notes and just imagine what it would sound like playing the Prelude in C-sharp minor by Rachmaninoff or something like that. That's what keeps me going. I've got to make a frame out of steel. I would really like the frame to be cast iron, but because it's so big, I don't think we'll be able to get a sandbox big enough to cast it in one piece. I've got to put strings in, that's the obvious one. And I've got to put an action, got to assemble an action into the piano, which is sort of the heart of the piano.
I mean, as you might well understand, there are no instructions out there to build a piano of this size. So it's Adrian's engineering skills that have had to work the concept out as far as the design goes.
I have a book now, which is, it says about how, to construct a piano, and it has all these lots of information, and I've been reading over that, and there's quite a bit to it. When I started this, I knew, nothing of what I know now, and I still probably don't know, you can never know everything about constructing pianos, but
one for perseverance, I think, and he's a very good craftsman, and has special skills that way. And I think just about every weekend for the last 18 months since the piano's been here, he's been up here tinkering away at it, and bit by bit, it's taking shape. It's all out of recycled timber.
Yeah, it's my first one. I restored a piano, which is at my house, and it's a lovely piano. It's an upright, it's a Harcat. It sat outside in the rain for a year, and that's the piano that taught me a lot of how to do things and what not to do, because there's a lot of that. And yeah, I asked piano tuners questions and things like that. Just, you know, oh, where do you get this from, or how do you do that? Things like that. Some are quite supportive, some aren't. It's just like anything, though. You have your critics, but they keep you going. They make you want to finish it more, prove them wrong.
You got the soundboard here. This is the structure that's got to hold all the... It basically holds the frame from warping. Because you can imagine all the strain of, you know, 20 to 30 tonnes pulling on a frame this long, it's going to want to warp. So I've had to put, you know, huge, big, thick beams and things in to stop it from warping. And to hold it up over the length, because you've got the leg there and you've got the other legs right at the other end. And it could be a 2-tonne frame. So, yeah, if the frame will support itself over the length, but to stop it from warping, I had to put this wooden structure in.
The problem is that is a big instrument, and also the weight of it's going to be quite a problem, I think.
Oh, some say, oh, it can't be done. Straight out, can't be done. But it can be. It is possible, anything's possible. Well, I just, it's like when I started playing, I just started playing. It didn't, it just happened. it's hard to describe. It's something you have to hear. And I suppose you either like it or you love it, but I mean, everyone that's heard it loves it. And, it's hard to even compare to something else. It's just a different sort of a sound. It's not hugely different, like it's out of place, but it's just more clear. It's really nice. I just like it. Bass, because that's what this piano's got. It's got bass, and hopefully I can get the treble right so I can balance the treble with the bass, and it would just be a nice playing piano.